Hey, and welcome to Tech Riffs. My name is Killian. If this is your first time with us here on the Tech Riffs channel, let me give you a quick tour. Tech Riffs was created as part of Worksighted's next program to bring you awesome content aimed at helping you operate with efficiency and be the tech superhero in your organization. We've done a few episodes this season around the many capabilities of Microsoft Teams, and today we are going to take on the Autocomplete challenge. We've simply gone to our web browser and typed in words like Microsoft Teams how, and let the search history of the masses determine the rest of the question. So, without further ado, let's dig in. Oh, this is gonna be weird. Becca, Microsoft Teams, how?
Do I install it?
How do you install Microsoft Teams? Ah, starting off with a good one. Okay, so if you go to portal.office365.com, sign in with your Office 365 credentials, and right now it's in the upper right-hand corner, there's like an install Office button. Click that guy, it'll start downloading it, it'll install the entire Office suite, including Microsoft Teams for you. Do you do meetings? There's a couple different ways to do meetings, but one of my favorite ways to do meetings is to just like open up a chat with somebody, and you can click on their picture, and you can click, there's like a meet now or something like that. If you send an Outlook invite, you can, in the ribbon, like you're making the invite or whatever, you could say make it a Teams meeting. It'll like auto-populate everything in there. It's super awesome. And then when it's time for your meeting, you just click on the event in the calendar, and then you can start the meeting from there. Two for two. Whoa. How do I use it? Oh boy. Oh, okay, so basically you do it. You just use it. There's all sorts of different stuff you can do in Microsoft Teams, so obviously we don't wanna jump into that. But basically it's gonna come up, you're gonna sign in. On the right-hand side, there's gonna be a couple different options. One of the most common ones is chat, so you can click chat, and then you basically start typing in the name of anybody in your organization. Usually it'll auto-populate. You can start chatting with them just like you've been doing since those old, you know, AIM days. My nickname, I think, was Killdog40 back in eighth grade or something. The other more common thing is you have different teams in there. Click that, and then all the different, like, basically organizational groups in your, you know, in your organization are in there, and then you can kind of interact that way. And there are so many cool tech riffs that are gonna explain it way better than whatever that was that just came out of my mouth. So look for those. How to create a team. So basically, all the way at the bottom, there's a gear, and I think you can create a team in there. You click add team, and then basically what it does is you can name it, and then you can add people to it. Microsoft Teams, how?
Do I get Killian to name me?
Oh boy. Becca, Microsoft Teams, how? Oh boy. So anyways, to create a, the share the screen, you're in the meeting, and then there's an option in there. Down usually at the bottom, like if you wiggle your mouse, the options will pop up and you can share your screen. Becca, Microsoft Teams, how?
Do you download files?
So basically, the way that you do that is if you're in the team, it could be like all staff team or something like that, or field team or whatever it is. You're looking at the team and there's like a ribbon up at the top, and there'll be like a files thing up there. You can click that, and then all your files will show up in there. You can upload files in there. You can connect things like Dropbox. You can have your OneDrive stuff in there. So there's all sorts of different cool stuff you can do in there. All right, I think we're on our last one, Becca, thankfully. This has been fun, but also awkward, but pretty fun. It's been fun. Becca, Microsoft Teams, how?
Well, this is the number one most searched for thing about Microsoft Teams.
Yeah.
How do I delete a conversation or chat?
I actually have no clue. And I'm surprised I've never, because I've tried to do it and I can't do it, I can't figure it out. We might have to look it up because I don't know. And if other people have looked it up, it must be pretty important. Okay, so you kind of just hover over the message and you can click the three dots, you know, the ellipses that pop up. But you have to have permissions to do it. I mean, you can delete your stuff, you can't delete anybody else's. That's good to know. I am curious to know why people, what are you guys looking to delete? Naughty, naughty. And anything online, you can never delete it. That's like, that's an age-old advice for everybody out there. So don't put it on there if you don't mean it. You just never know. All right, that's it for today's Tech Riffs. Make sure to check out the other videos on our channel to see if maybe we've already answered a tech question you might have. And if we haven't, then use that comment section to let us know what you'd like us to riff on next. Until then, I'm Killian Smith. Take it easy. I'm a nerd. I like bagpipe music. If she plays the pipes, that's probably a pretty good. It's probably a pretty good first step.
Probably a pretty slim pickings there.
It is. I'm very single.